Hi folks, I'm Adam, and for today's video, I'll be demonstrating a few ways in which an enderpearl cannon can be improved with the 1.5 snapshots. Sorry if I sound a bit off, it's been approaching freezing in our house for the last 24 hours, but we got the heating back on now, so let's do this thing. If you've never seen an enderpearl cannon before, the idea is pretty simple. You light some TNT, you throw an enderpearl at it whilst it explodes, and that sends the enderpearl much further than you could usually throw it. So, normally you'd spend a good year manually loading up all of the TNT into the system, and then you've got to ignite it, wait for that, and then finally the enderpearl can launch itself. However, with the 1.5 snapshots, there's multiple features that have been introduced that can automate and accelerate the process. For starters, I can both load and manually set the strength of this cannon just by placing TNT carts in this chest. I'll place in 3 for now, but there's not really a limit, that I've found anyway, on how many you can put in the chest. If you follow it round, you can see there are hoppers leading up to this dispenser, which places all of the carts on top of one another on an unpowered rail. Now, when I click on the button on the front of the machine, it will launch these carts by powering the rail, causing them to explode in this water. The time it takes for these carts to explode is much faster than the ignition time of TNT, which speeds up the process even further. At the same time as the carts are launched, the fence gate will be withdrawn. The idea is that whilst you're waiting for the TNT to explode, you hold down right click on the fence with the enderpearl equipped. When the fence moves, the enderpearl is thrown at the precise timing and then launched skyward. As for command blocks, I've put these here purely to switch you in and out of creative mode because you can't throw enderpearls whilst you're in creative. However, the rest of this contraption is otherwise easily built in survival mode. We've already loaded it up, so all you need to do is grab a single enderpearl, hit this button, hold down right click on the fence post. I find that you get the best angle by aiming at the small slit of light between the piston head and the gate, so we'll aim there. Right, let's give this thing a go. Did you see that rocket away? We're at roughly 0-0 at the moment, so let's see how far this thing takes us. Aha, here we go. Over 200 blocks with a single enderpearl. However, there's no need to stop here. I've filled up the entire loading chest with TNT carts to see just how far it would take me, and the 27 and they managed to take me over 2,000 blocks away. Unfortunately, by that point, the enderpearl is entering unloaded chunks and won't teleport you until you move closer to it and load the chunks. For distances that great, you'd probably need to be running some form of mod or be on a very busy server or something like that. But still, the technology's there, and now it's even easier to use. Well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.